Our Montgomery County reporter joins us with the latest tonight. Living life like this.
We are going to go live here soon. Now give me a second. We're gonna get turned up here for a sec. We about to get cranked up, y'all. It's coming. Don't worry. Starting to soon this Logic track go off. That's my guy right there. Logic is the truth, boy. Hello, 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 my people. What's happening? I'm putting the headphones on. We're going to get us go ahead and cranked up. Look, right on time. Hello, hello, fam. I know. Can you hear me now? Is that better? How about that? Oh, y'all still hearing some little Logic, aren't you? Let's go ahead and get this thing going. Miami going to win tonight, y'all? Somebody tell me yes. Somebody tell me Miami gonna win tonight. Yes. Who I got in the room? Who I got? Today's a good day. I actually feel good about today's game. I got something special to show y'all for real though. It's gonna be a lot of fun. All right, here we go. I'm gonna turn the lights down. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Miami Game Day, baby. It's time to go down like a plane crash. How's everybody doing tonight? Hey, you guys, let me know who's in the room. Let me see who's up in the room. I would love to know. Let's just get started. Who's in the room? I think I can actually see. Can I peep in? What's up, peeps? I am interested in getting started on this game. Let me tell you something. I think it's going to be a real fun game for us. I think we're going to see the Miami that we showed everybody the last couple weeks. My son's here. He's going to do his prediction. My boy Richie Rich, the quarterback. He's a beast. Who's in the room? Y'all give me some shout outs. Who am I talking to? Let me see what's happening. Would like to know who is in the room. Y'all bear with me. I've been getting a little sick, so I've been like fighting through it. I've been doing a lot of movies and stuff, man. It's been crazy. Miami versus Duke Blue Devils. Who I got in the room? Who got in the room? Let me see. Who am I talking to in the window? Let's see. All messages are visible. Somebody talk to me. Who I got? We got three in. I'm gonna give y'all a couple more people. Let's do about three more minutes, unless some people get in here as well. I'm gonna bump a little more logic, and then we're gonna get started. I need some shout outs. So, who you are? Where you from? What's happening with you? You've been watching any games? What games are you paying attention to? What do you think about what's going on with Miami? Y'all start chatting, and we're gonna get up in here. Who ready to talk? Let's do this. Who I got in the room tonight, baby? Go give me that number 6 jersey. My son about to give me the Santana Moss. I got my Calvin Capone shirt on. If you guys don't know, I am a rapper. I've been in the game for 22 years. Now I'm a videographer. I'm gone. He told me I got to go orange, so we're going orange. How about that? That make you feel better? Yeah. Yeah. Who's in the room? Somebody talk to me. Let me see what's going on. We're going to get started. End of this song. 3 minutes and 40 seconds. I'm going to start up. Regardless who's in and who's out, we can go ahead and do this thing. How y'all been doing, man? What y'all think about this whole Miami Hurricane situation? Did y'all see the game last night? Somebody talk to me. I'm going to message my boy Coop and my boy Zoe. Let's see what's going on. What's happening? My son's right here. My quarterback. He's a beast. All right, Lonzo just getting home from work. He probably jump on here and say, whoever's in the chat, let's talk. I'm going to do live chat as well. You guys will be able to open up with me. So we're going to do some talking. I'm going to let you guys call my direct line. My wife thinks I'm crazy for doing that. I want to thank everybody, too, that's been following me, man. I got the Cozy Perry video. I think it's had like 8,000 views right now. Which is all good, like I said. And I'm gonna explain some stuff tonight, man. I ain't hating on the young man. Oh, and I got a special present for you guys. It's gonna come at the end during my score prediction. Yeah. All right, we're getting ready to get started. Yeah. 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 Theo, what's up, man? How you doing? Hey, you know what? You right on time because of my Logic song just ended. I love Logic. If you guys do not know about Logic, I need to check them out. So, yes, let's do this. Miami is in the building. They're warming up right now. Game starts in about 42 minutes. 52 minutes. Sorry. Man, let me tell y'all something. It hurts me that Miami is not as good as we think they are. They should be, but it's okay. Guess what? If you guys have not seen what game was yesterday? What game was last night? Theo, what game was last night? ACC. I posted it earlier. The Virginia game, was that last night? And they lost. Virginia Pitt was last night. They lost. Right now, if Miami wins out, there will be – if Miami wins out and beats all the teams they have to play – yes, it was Pitt. Thank you, sir. Do you know there would be like a five-way tie in the Coastal? I'm sorry right now, but, man, I watched NCAA game day today, and, man, the Coastal is probably one of the worst divisions in football. Anyhow, let's talk the truth. Let's talk the truth. What's up, Rich? How you doing, man? Yeah, it was Pitt. Yeah, Pitt versus Virginia. Pitt won for the fifth time in a row. If you guys did not check that Georgia Tech game, which I'm not even sure what the final score was, I'm actually going to have my son. He's sitting next to me, my boy Rich. I'm going to have him actually go through and pull up. Here we go. Boston College, Virginia Tech is on right now. Give me just a second. I was outside throwing football with him because we do quarterback practice. And he wanted to throw, so I made sure I threw with him. All right, so you know me, your boy Dirk the Shield, Slapper TV. I like to do stats. So let's start off with this. Duke Blue Devils, 5-3. Their losses come to Virginia Tech, Virginia, and Pitt, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's so important. Their wins, Northwestern, which they won. They beat Northwestern at the beginning of the season, which is interesting because Northwestern has been running the Pac-10 right now. Pac-10, Pac-12. I was getting confused. Other win, they beat Baylor. NC Central, that don't count. And Army, I can't really say it counts. But the win-loss record versus their teams is 36-26. So they are 5-3. Versus 36-26 teams. So teams above 500. I watched their defense. Their defense is slow. And I know what you guys are saying. Director Chill, you said the same thing last week versus Virginia and Boston College. And I was right. Their defense is still slow. But anyhow, they run a slow D. They run a 4-3. Here's the thing. Duke runs shotgun every play. There is no ace. There's no split back. It's nothing. They run shotgun every play. They run a lot of read option, which is kind of interesting. They got a nice quarterback. Also, you got to watch out for Jackson and Brown. Running back, Jackson 534 on the season, Brown 325 on the season. So you know what? The more that I look at stats about teams that we're playing, the more disappointed that I am. Because the last three games that we have played, I put up all the stats, and still we lost, and we should have won. I watched – what game was I watching earlier? I was watching the Florida State game. Granted, they suck. I think they're 4-4. I'm not sure if they won or not, but they still run a better offense than we do. All right, so Dorian – MC, he said, not feeling good about this game. Gonna be a dogfight. Honestly, Dorian, every game we're gonna play, and I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. I don't mean, you know, disrespect you, but you're right. Every game we play is gonna be a dogfight. We're just not that damn good, and it's crazy. I was on the phone with my boy Alonzo. He just got home from work. He's gonna try to jump on later. I know he says he's doing halftime and he's doing post game. I might do post game this game. If we lose, I'm probably gonna do post game because I get pissed off. But anyhow, you know what? Let's just talk about the truth. Deadass. We're gonna have to bring this up right now. John Rick. Is he that bad? I'm gonna give y'all a little stat. This is a stat that I had expressed with Lonzo yesterday. And we weren't debating or anything. Yes, Taryn said yes. Let me express something to you guys. I live in Georgia. the top three quarterbacks that came out of Elite 11 last season, as in they are freshmen now. One is Trevor Lawrence at Clemson. Two is Justin Fields at Georgia. And three is Darren Williams. All three from the state of Georgia. I watched all three of them play. I watched Trevor and I watched Justin Fields play live. Justin Fields actually went to Harrison High School, which is my rival, North Cobb, and we beat them 46-45. So I watched all three. So the best three quarterbacks out of last year's draft came from the state of Georgia. Guess which one has not started a game yet? Don't worry. I'll fucking wait. Y'all already know what the answer is. Yes. Our boy. Now, I can say all I want to. I know you guys, I've got a lot of people out there mad at me because they think like I'm trying to shoot bullets at Nikosi. Nikosi's my guy. I don't give a fuck what anybody thinks. That's my guy. I want him to play. But honestly, does it really matter? Our offense is so atrocious. So let's talk about John. John Rick, let's talk about him. Somebody raise your hand if you think he has any experience as a quarterback coach. Terrence, Dorian, Rich, Theo, me, my son's right here. Does anybody think he has any experience? You know he got the job. This is what's hurting us right now. Mark Rick got his son a job for the free ski. Yes, he donated $1 million. And yes, our indoor facility is off the chain. Don't get me wrong. Terrence said, if we had a real quarterback coach, Karen would be starting. Yeah, you're right. Theo said, what? Yeah, Jaron. Thank you. Jaron. Did I say Karen? I'm sorry. Jaron Williams. Jaron Williams. I'm sorry. I can't remember the boy's name because he doesn't play. I know he went to South Quinnette High School, which is north of Atlanta here in Georgia. But yeah, he doesn't play. I believe we redshirted him. I think we are in a shit storm, and people do not want to admit it. You guys realize this. At the end of the season, we could see Manny Diaz find a head coaching job. My wife is a Tennessee fan. They're already searching to make – Tennessee has already contacted Diaz to be the starting coach at Tennessee. And also, we have three linebackers. Pickney, McLeod, damn it, too much tequila. Pickney, McLeod, and I can't think of the other name. My bad, you guys, my bad. But all three of them are juniors right now. They all could go to NFL draft. I mean, dead ass. Like, we could lose our defensive coordinator, and we also could lose six, seven players to the NFL next year. I don't know if you guys remember, but there was a time when Miami was putting more players in the NFL than we had wins. So, I don't even know what to say about that. So, let me bring back some more of this Duke situation. They beat Baylor 40-27, which was nice. NC Central, which is minus Bill Welby, a D2 team. Pickney was the other one. My bad, guys. Pickney was the other one. They beat Georgia Tech, which is kind of interesting because in Georgia Tech, after that game, they put up like 66 against Virginia Tech. I mean, Georgia Tech has literally been throttling people. So it's so interesting how that goes. And they beat Army, which runs the option, which what Georgia Tech runs. So it seems like if they have time to plan, then they can do very good. I'm just like still debating and still understanding, like, why is it? What do you guys think? Do you guys see Mark Rick still being our coach next year? Anybody? Is anybody see? All right, so Dorian, I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. So you still see, honestly, I mean, you drop $1 million in a system in a school where you actually went. Hoping he's not our offense. It's a crazy thing, though. What's up with the offensive coordinator situation? Why? Mishap. Yep. Yep. Simply because we can't afford to pay his body. You're right. We can't afford. He put down $1 million. And then he got his son. I think John Rick is making like $250,000 a year for the next 2 years. Because this is year three, right? So 5 year contract or 4 year contract, $250,000 a year. What's up, Linda? I'm so glad that you joined. I talked to you earlier. That would be no good for us to lose them. What's up, Cal? Miami Mike. Listen, man, is it not crazy the fact that we have literally painted ourselves in a corner that we cannot get out of? I mean, you guys have watched the plays. You know, I know I'm going to go over. And like I said, I'm going to hit you one more time. Duke, they run us. They got a slow defense. They look just like Boston College. All their DBs are short. They run a 4-3 defense. Usually it's an offset, which means their strong side, which is the right side, is normally over the tight end. So it means it's not three linebackers in the middle of the four, but they kind of shift to the right. All right. They run a lot. All they run is shotgun. Honestly, I mean, I might as well just stop it and just say everybody in ACC runs a shotgun, because pretty much everybody does except for the winners, and that would be NC State runs mace, Boston College runs mace, and Clemson runs ace and shotgun. I think I even saw Clemson run split back this year. And then they run a lot of read option. Our defense is fast. Someone comment. Do you guys think that our defense has given up? And I don't mean like they giving up on the team. I just feel like, all right, for instance, I'm a Seattle Seahawks fan, right? I remember after we lost that Super Bowl to the Patriots, right, when we should have ran the fucking ball and we didn't. You remember the old face that Richard Sherman had? The next season, which would have been last year, so not this year, but last year, the defense was like, I'm just trying to get a contract. I don't give a damn because offense ain't going to do it. That's how I feel about the Miami defense right now. Honestly, I think we got 7 players right now that will go to the league. Anybody else agree with me? Please let me know. I'm about to open up the phone lines too. So your guys want to call me directly on my phone. What do y'all think? Do you think the defense is tired of the bullshit? And I understand there's not a ton of people on here right now. I know it's kind of weird to do a Miami game day because we play late. I have no idea where they had us playing at 7 o'clock. I think they thought we were going to be good by this time. But unfortunately, it's not looking too good. But anybody, yeah, let me know. I'm looking at some. Oh, God. All right, this is what I'm looking at right now. So I'm pulling up stuff because, like I said, I've been busy. The Hurricanes hope the cheers will drown out the booze Saturday at Hard Rock. Why is Rozier keeping his starting job at Miami? And this is not me. This is the fan base. Terrence said, nah, they still balling, but if the offense doesn't tonight or doesn't listen. I'm sorry. I know you might have a little typo. I don't even know what to say. I'm like, last year we were the Cardiac Canes. Let me ask you a question. And I'm going to ask this question. I'm going to give y'all about a minute to respond. Who would prefer us being the Cardiac Canes that we were last year, where we damn near had a heart attack every game compared to this year? Which basically by the third or fourth quarter, we knew we were out of it. Who would rather be the Cardiac Kings from last year or what we are now? My bad. Yeah, we got to get it done, Terrence. You're right. If we don't get it done, man, we are in a shit storm. Do you know 2 years ago, and I'm from Georgia, and all the Georgia fans said, oh, Mark Rick, he's not going to win any big games. You know what I told him? I was really defensive. I said, y'all get off my fucking coach. Right now, he can't really be my coach. He's kind of whack right now. Dead ass. And the only reason why I'm looking up, because I'm looking at the score, Boston College 21, Virginia Tech 14. Are you guys ready for me to open up the line? I know everybody's watching the games. It's not like last week where we had like 100 and something people on because we were the only people playing on Friday. So, who would rather us be the cardiac canes from last year than the, I don't even know what you would call us this year. I mean, I want to know. I want to know what y'all think. I honestly think that if, and I'm not sure about the numbers, but if Virginia Tech loses this game and Boston College wins, and you guys will correct me if I'm right or am I wrong. If Boston College beats Virginia Tech, no, Boston College is on the other side. So, never mind. That doesn't even matter. If we lose tonight, don't think I'm going to next week's game. Hey, Terrence, you're in Atlanta. I was going to go to the game as well. I decided to wait to see if we beat Virginia. And I told my wife they have some good-ass tickets. And I told her, I said, if Miami beat Virginia, then we'd pay for tickets. And we lost. And then we lost last week. And honestly, like, I'm granted, I can go probably go to the Miami-Georgia Tech game for, like, $20. But, you know, each. All we can do is watch, hope. How could you have Larry? Man, I love my Rick. You know what I'm saying? I'm a Christian man myself, and I love the way that he handled his team. You guys, I don't know if a lot of you people remember, but I was signed to Def Jam Records. I'm a recording artist. So in 2006, I was signed to Def Jam Records, and they had a small studio in Athens. And I went down there, and that's when Georgia had Greg Blue. And he said $33 each. Damn, that sucks. And I went out there and I actually met Mark, and Mark was cool, and he's a Christian man. He's got daughters, and I respected him. That's the reason why I like Rick, because I respected him. I was not a Georgia fan, so I really didn't pay attention to what his record showed. But then I remember a lot of people telling me, like, he's been there 15 years, and the best he is a 10-win coach. And I told everybody, if he could win 10 in the SEC, then he can win 11 or 12 in the ACC, which will put us in the ACC championship every year. So that's kind of how I derived to where I'm at. $33 each. That is ridiculous. Oh, before I go live, I'm about to put my number up, and you guys can start calling in. The Miami Dolphins. I'm not a Miami Dolphin fan. Like I said, I'm from Seattle. But Rex Ryan said the Miami Dolphins have the – this is so ironic, even though their team is not that good. The Miami Dolphins have the best home field advantage. And do you know what they said why? Miami always wears – and the Dolphins always wear white at home, and it's very hot, and they make the road teams wear the colored jerseys. So how interesting is that? Because we play in the same damn stadium. So wouldn't that make a little sense? I mean, not that it's going to matter as the season goes on, but it's still hot in Miami. So, anyhow, I'm going to open up the phone lines. I want to hear what you guys got to say. I'm kind of going to shut my mouth, and I want to have – I think my daughter just woke up. Go check on her. I think my daughter just woke up. Yes, Terrence, that's very interesting. But watch NFL Live. They literally said Miami Dolphins have the best home field advantage, and they wear white at home. And they make the other teams, the road teams, wear dark, and they're burning their ass up and getting cramps and all that shit. So I'm just interested. Like, why couldn't, like, Mark Rick at least even try it? But anyhow, my phone number is about to go in chat. I don't have Skype. You guys will literally be calling me on my cell phone number, 422-0060. Open up the line. Call me. I want to hear what you guys got to say. I'm going with this my gold mic a little bit. This is the one I recorded like my last 7 albums with. This is dope. You guys call, I answer. You talk, I listen. Let's just do it. Sorry about the nose. Oh, is Bookie's up? Oh, I thought that's what I heard. All right, so we're gonna go live, you guys. You guys give me a ring. Terrence, Theo, Linda, Richard. Any of you guys call? Anybody want to talk? Let's blab and blab. We're at 29 minutes, which means literally the Miami game starts in 30 minutes. So I want to hear what you guys got to say. Give me a ring. 470-422-0060. Calvin Capone. The BC game is 21-14 right now. $33 each. And it, Terrence, is that just for the Georgia Tech game, or is that like all of them? Or I mean, Linda, I want to win out. Let me tell you something, Linda. If we went out, I asked you guys this last week. Do y'all even think that we could beat Florida or Central? Somebody give me your top five. Somebody call in right now. 470-422-0060. Somebody call in right now and tell me your top three teams in the state of Florida. Are we in the top three? Is it Florida, Central Florida, South Florida, then Miami? Florida National, Florida Atlantic. I ain't gonna put Florida State in there because I feel sorry for him. My best friend's a Florida State fan, and he's like, man, we suck. And I'm like, man, you have no idea what sucking is. Hey, but we still got five rings. Yes, sir. Y'all already know this. I got replicas of all five. I had someone hate on me. They were like, oh, yeah, you ain't no real Miami fan. You can buy them on eBay. Yeah, I fucking bought them on eBay. But only a real fan would make sure they had all replicas. I got jerseys, hats. I got signs. I got rings. I'm a fucking Miami fan. So I want to know where all the haters are at right now. Tommaso, I've been hating on the Coastie Perry. I ain't hating on the Coastie Perry, but he wants to be our quarterback. Let's act like one. You guys call in 470-422-0060. I think we might be in trouble. Virginia Tech is losing this game right now. Is Boston College that good? I'm actually going to pull up some stats. I'm waiting on calls. I got the itchy throat. Sucks right now. Let's look. Let's go to sports. Let's see what's happening. Yes, we play at 7. You guys realize that we are a 9.5-point favorite? Which we've been a favorite in every game this year, except for LSU. No, I take that back. Even the LSU game, we were a 2.5 favorite. So they said we were going to win by at least a field goal. How interesting is that? We have been a favorite in every game this year and have not done anything to prove we are good as they say we are. Let's see. I feel bad for my dad. He's from Kentucky, so he's a big Kentucky fan. And they got spanked by Georgia. But, hey, you guys think LSU is as good as everybody think they are? They must be because they jumped 14 spots when they beat our ass. How about that? And we dropped 14 spots. But you know what? When Ohio State lost to Purdue, who wasn't even ranked, they only dropped 9 spots. How about that for disrespect? How about that for disrespect? Let's see. Georgia, Kentucky, 31-17. Florida State, NC State. Oh, my God. 44-21. Is anybody watching that game? Is there any Miami fans that would rather have really a Willie Taggart than Mark Richt? I honestly thought that Oregon offense would be slapping. Literally slapping. If you guys do not know, my TV show is called Slapping TV. Slapping is a verb. It means awesome. It means off the chain. Is it a verb? Adverb. Yes, adverb. Let's see what scores. I'm going to go through some scores for you right now. Standings. Let's go to ACC. Clemson, Boston College, Syracuse, NC State, Florida State, Wake Forest, Louisville. This is what we have in the Coastal right now. Pitt, number one. Who won last night? Virginia Tech, number 2, 3-1. Virginia, 4-2, who beat us, so they got the lead. Georgia Tech, 3-3. We have not played yet, and then us. So here's the thing. If we beat Georgia Tech, Virginia Tech beat Virginia, and we went out, you guys realize we are number one in the Coastal. Now, does that really matter, though? My son says no, it doesn't really matter. I mean, it literally does not matter. I mean, the way we're playing, who cares if we win the Coastal? Who wants to see us get spanked by Clemson next year or the end of the season? Nobody. You guys think Clemson is? What's up, Shane? You guys think Clemson is good as everybody says they are? Clemson, Boston College, Syracuse, NC State. Top four in Atlantic. Pitt, Virginia Tech, Virginia, Georgia Tech. Top four in the Coastal. Like I said, three of those teams in the Coastal we have not played yet. We still have to play Georgia Tech, Virginia Tech, and Pitt. If Virginia Tech beats Virginia and we went out, you guys realize that we will be playing for the ACC championship. Linda says she wants to see us win out and play Bama. Everybody says that, Linda. I don't think anybody wants to really play Bama right now. I'll tell you this right now, though. I know Bama better be focused on LSU. How about that? How about that quarterback that came from Ohio State is a lot better than anybody said he was. Everybody said he was a quitter, and he just wanted to go find somewhere to start, and you see what he did to us, and you see what he did to Georgia. I mean, granted, they lost to Florida, so I kind of understand that, but still. Them boys, LSU ain't no joke. My family's from Louisiana. They're from South Texas. From Houston, Louisiana. Boo, Ohio State. Ohio State can suck it. There's no team I hate worse than Ohio State. Let's look. Who do Ohio State play today, Bobby? Or are they on bye? Penn State, Michigan. Michigan is beating the shit out of Penn State right now. Who you got winning, Bama? I got LSU, Shane, all day. I got to have them. Hold on. Stop. He said Nebraska. Quit it. Hey, check this out. A score alert. Florida, 10. Missouri, 35. Ohio State, Nebraska. Nebraska's garbage. How about this? Florida, 10. Missouri, 35. How about that? And by the way, that Virginia Tech and Boston State game or Boston College game is nowhere near over. There's a lot of time. I want Pear or even J. Will. Jaren Williams is the fucking truth. Like I said, the best three players in the NCAA out of the recruiting class of last year all come from the state of Georgia. Justin Fields, Trevor Lawrence, and Jaren Williams. 1, 2, and 3. Respectively. Do you guys realize? Hold on. I don't think a lot of people know this. Go back and look at the Elite 11 game, high school game from last year. You know, Elite 11, they don't have any pads. They got those ugly ass little plastic helmet things on. Do you realize that Jaren Williams was supposed to go to the University of Kentucky? How about that? And I know they lost today. Could you imagine? Kentucky, who just got throttled by Georgia, but if they had had Jaren Williams and they probably would have started him, do you know how good they would have been this year? Oh my God. Clemson versus LSU, 77-16. Ugh. Ohio State, wait. Somebody said that was not the final. Ohio State 36. Oh, yeah. Never mind, Rich. You did say that was the final. Excuse me, guys. Like I said, I've been fighting the cold. Hey, what up? My boy calls football. Hey, Coop, will you call in, please? I want to hear what you got to say. I know I missed your video yesterday. I've been telling everybody I have been sick. So I have been fighting a damn cold. Coop, call in. I'm going to put you on speakerphone. I want to hear what you got to say. We've been going over a bunch of little things. But like I was telling everybody, with the Boston College, right? So Boston College, Virginia Tech is 14-21. Okay. Boston College is on the other side, so it doesn't matter. If Virginia Tech, the last three games we play Georgia Tech, we play Virginia Tech, and we play Pitt, okay? If Virginia Tech beats Virginia and we went out, we are in there like swimwear. I want to know what someone has to say. Coop, give me a call. We only got like 23 minutes left until the game starts, so... Shane, this is Linda's husband. Oh, my bad. All right. So, Shane. Hi, Shane. This is Linda's husband. I used her account. She is not into football. Hey, Shane. Linda won't let you get an account? You best stay away from them chicks, bro. They will get you in trouble. I know college football viz. Hey, Coop, you already know, man. I think we can do it, but do we want to see that? Honestly, my heart is a lot better these days than we were last year with the cardiac canes. And I apologize, you guys. Like I said, I've been fighting the damn cold last couple days. And I've been working on like three movies. Coop, call in, please. I know you probably just got home. If you got time, call in. Let me know what you think. I missed your show last night. I literally was in bed by like 8:30 last night. And I woke up at like 12. I think I woke up at 12:15. My wife had Hallmark Channel on watching Christmas movies. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Yeah, she got rid of my damn Discovery Channel just so. Let me see if I can get. Oh, yeah. You could, Coop. So you guys understand this. We got a chance. I'm going to give you some more. I'm going to give you the numbers again. Duke versus Baylor, 40-27 win. They beat Baylor. Baylor's 4-4 now. NC Central, not that it matters, 3-4, 55-13 was the win for Duke. Virginia Tech. Duke lost 31-14 was a loss, which Virginia Tech is 4-3 as of right now. They look like they're going to be 4-4 because Boston College looks like they're getting in there like swimmer. Georgia Tech 28-14, and they're 4-4. Let me look. Did Georgia Tech win that game? Are you standing during the game? Oh, Lord. Let's see. Did Georgia Tech win that game? Anybody holler at me, let me know. Let's see. NCAA football, ACC. Here we go. Sorry, I'll be watching all types of stuff. I'm from the West Coast, so NC State is thrashed in Florida State. Boston College winning, like I said. Pitt beat Virginia. So Virginia's not ranked anymore. They were 25. Syracuse, 41-24. They are going up, but they're on the other side, so it does not matter. Theo, I do not stay on during the game. Sometimes I get up and I go in front of the TV and I start literally clapping. I do 5 claps for every Miami Hurricane ring. Georgia Tech beat North Carolina. So we literally have a mosh pit in the ACC Coastal. I mean, literally anybody can win. Here's the thing. And I know it doesn't look like it's going to happen, but if Boston College somehow beats Pitt, I'm sorry. If Boston College somehow beat Virginia Tech, let's see. Well, I won't say it will be all tied, but really, at the end of the day, we're literally looking at like a 5-way tie. Pitt, Virginia Tech, Virginia, Georgia Tech, and Miami. All of them. All up in there. Shane, I remember when we beat Nebraska in 84, fumble risk. Oh, Lord have mercy. The sun over here, eating pancakes and bacon and shit. I don't know what the hell going on. Look, they're showing some shit. Hey, are any of you guys Miami basketball fans or baseball? I want to know because I want to continue doing my live streams. I love Miami baseball, even though I'm not a baseball fan, but the only baseball team I root for is Miami. And of course, I love Miami basketball, but basketball is a little funny because we play so many games. Well, I think NCAA basketball is like 30 games. I normally don't pick up until March Madness. The way my life goes, it's college football and college football only, except for fantasy football. And then when college football ends, then I'm NFL. And then when NFL ends, then I'm March Madness. And when March Madness ends, then I'm NCAA, which is – or not NCAA, but NBA, which is funny because I'm from Seattle. I don't have the Supersonics anymore. So really, I don't give a damn who wins in the NBA. But I was just wondering. Yes, Joseph Miami fan. I've seen 30 for 30, so I know what that is. Yes. Yeah, Shane, man. You know that shit crazy is. The 34 Fumble Ruski. You guys realize Miami should actually have 7 rings right now. They cheated us, of course, the Ohio State game that everybody knows. They cheated us that Notre Dame game where Jimmy Johnson told them if you leave it up to the ref's hands, they're going to let Miami win. And then a lot of people say that Alabama game or that Nebraska game, we could have won either one of those two. So Joseph said, yeah, basketball. I mean, I love Miami basketball. We've been a lot better lately. with Jim Noreika, but I don't know, man. We just don't do a lot of basketball down there, so. You are soon. True. What up? Slapping. Glenn, what's happening? I know, man. Yeah, man, I've been struggling, man, with this damn cold and shit. I got a buddy on here. I don't know if you guys know him. Anybody watch Alonzo 1216? I think is his name. I fuck with him. You know what I'm saying? He cool shit. I think he like hates my Rick to death. Like I said, I respect my Rick regardless. All right, so cool then. Yeah, let's do some basketball. I would definitely continue on Miami basketball. I am actually a recording artist, and I'm also a video editor. So, Glenn, I heard that's not the truth. I don't want to bring up any conflict between the two because I love both of those brothers. Coop is my boy, and Zoe is my boy. I heard there was some falling out, whatever, but we're still Miami Hurricane family, so... It is what it is. I'm kind of stuck in the middle because, like, I do my thing. And let me just say, like, I don't hold my tongue. But at the same time, like, I say what I got to say, and I respect the players and the coaches. Like, I love my Rick. Don't get me wrong. But at the same time, yeah, I mean, his play call is garbage. My son over here eating damn honey buns. I'm gonna bust his head. He got the come here. He's got the Bob Felicia jersey on. Hey, up in there. Yeah, he likes that one. I think that was the ugliest fucking jersey Miami ever had. But you know what's crazy? When we got it, I kind of liked it. That's the Brad Kye joint. 28-14 Virginia Tech. We are in the game in 14 minutes. It's so interesting. Listen, guys, I know that we struggled this year. I mean, I don't know where we're going to go. We're going to go up. Glenn, somebody, cool cat. Yeah, that's my boy. That's my boy right there for real. He's a quarterback. I've been training him at quarterback. He's actually, to be so tall as he is, he's only fourth grade. So I'm going to give him two more years of training him at quarterback. I played backup quarterback, and I was a number one wide receiver and All-American in high school. Every receiver. Now I look like a motherfucking tight end with all this damn dad belly. They're laughing at me. No, for real. Yeah, I know, Glenn. He's going to be a beast. He's got an arm out the ass. I'm just trying to keep him humble. I don't want him getting all crazy, but I want him going to Miami. It's crazy. His mom is a Tennessee fan. Of course, her family's from Georgia, so they're Georgia fans. And then her dad's side has family in South Carolina. So I have no idea what the fuck I'm going on. Found Zoe first, which led to Coop, who led to you. Thanks for all you. Hey, Bobby, I appreciate it. You know what's so crazy? Like I said, if you guys actually have checked out, hey, Coop's calling. Let's talk. What up, though?
How's it going, my man?
Hey, what's up, man? You just finished getting done with work or something?
Yeah, well, no, I'm honestly being my wife. We're outside tossing around the old pigskin.
That's good, man. How you been? I was sick yesterday, so like I said, I went to bed at like 8 o'clock, so I missed your show, man, but I wanted to let you know that we were still doing the live thing today.
Good. Yeah, I meant to catch you right at 6 o'clock. That's my bad. I'm always running late, you know it. Everybody knows it.
Yeah, it's all good.
You gotta watch out. I saw Glenn in your chat. That man's a savage.
Yeah, I see. Hey, but he's a Coop fan, so I'm good with that.
Oh yeah, he is.
So what do you think? I missed your score prediction. I literally did not even watch the video. Me and my son. I did the Gameday video. He was my cameraman. He holds my camera the whole nine, but I actually did not see your score prediction. So, Coop, I'm going to open up the floor. I want to hear what you got to say.
Okay. It was the first time ever. Been making videos since the beginning of last season. First time ever that I gave two score predictions, and one of them has Miami losing. I know a lot of people got mad because they said, Coop, that's not fair. You can't give two score predictions. What the heck, man? But my thing is, I said, I'm not just trying to hate. But if Rozier starts the entire game, if he takes every snap, Miami drops this game, still a close one. I've got 24-13. If someone else takes some snaps, I don't care if it's Nikosi or Jaron. Miami wins, still a close one, though. I got Miami 21, Duke 17.
Okay.
And it, believe me, man, it hurts my heart to predict a potential loss, especially at home. But from what I've seen over the past couple of games, this is kind of how I'm feeling.
Okay, cool. I'm going to let you know something. And you know what? We're down to like 10 minutes. I got a secret. I got a secret for you guys. Hold on. I'm putting the phone down just for a sec.
I like secrets.
I like secrets too. I meant to show you guys this last week, but I didn't feel it. Cool. You're watching, right? You're watching. I'm about to show you guys something, right? I'm about to show you something. You guys know I shoot movies and stuff, right? This is going to give you a clue on the reason why we're going to win. You guys see this?
I'm ready.
You see that? Y'all see all that straight cash? This is movie money. Do you know why I'm showing you this? Nikosi Perry is going to play this game. I have a feeling that Mark Richt's going to put him in about the third quarter. We'll probably be down by about 14, maybe 7 points. And guess what's going to happen? He's going to go off so nasty. We might even see something on his Instagram about I told you so. He might even say my name on there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think I got a lot of hate from a lot of Miami fans because they feel like I was being too hard on the boy. I got Nikosi. You guys see this? Look, Glenn knows what's up. Remember I said 5,000? I don't think you guys noticed when I looked to the left. This is all prop. Look at all this money. This is all prop money. What do you think, Coop? Do you think Nikosi gets in this game?
I think he has to. I don't think we have any other choice. Because I do think that we'll go down a little bit early. Typical Miami fashion, again, not being a hater. You know I bleed that orange and green.
Yeah, always.
But I think we could scare early on, maybe 10-0, 14-0. You got to pull the trigger with Nikosi. And he takes the reins, takes command of the offense, and we take care of business.
Most definitely. I got you, Coop. I definitely agree. Glenn laughed at the money. Like I said, all that straight cash. And Coop is at punter. Hey, if Coop's at punter, can I please come in as a walk-in? I will play right guard. Let me play right tackle because I'm kind of fat these days. I was a wide receiver, but no more Coop.
Waiting on that phone call, maybe during the offseason.
Hey, you know what? I'm still waiting on the phone call from Ken Dorsey saying that he wants to come and be our offensive coordinator. Listen, I've been watching a lot of games, and you know I watch a lot of stats, man, and it's kind of crazy, and it makes me feel a little depressed inside when I watch these teams. And I hate to bring up Alabama, but on game day today,
that's a dirty word, man.
I know, but I watched Alabama, and you know how good their team is. And I watched them run a play where they ran the slot receiver in motion, faked it to him, faked it to the running back, and then with Tua, they ran a dive play, and it was so nasty. It was last game. And I was like, man, can we just get a little bit more? Like, what do you think, man? What's going to happen, Coop? Is Mark Richt going to end up getting an offense coordinator? Is he going to end up retiring? I mean, what do you think?
I know a lot of people right now, and I promise, I'm not pointing at anyone in particular because this stuff's going around a lot on the Category 6 page. Don't think anything's set in stone already. I think that's kind of crazy. I think that we have to. I've always said on all of my videos that as long as we're making progress every season, I'm fine with it. This was the first season that he's been here that's been a step back.
True.
So I think no matter what, I think there'll be enough of a push, especially even from alumni, because I think they even get more to say than we do. I mean, they can show up at the practices and talk to Mark Richt face-to-face.
True,
and
true.
I know they're upset about it. So
yeah,
I think that something will happen. The issue is everybody's talking money and stuff. Somebody will have to go. Something will have to be changed. Somebody's got to be moved somewhere. Somebody's got to take less. Somebody's got to be – I don't know. But if we bring in someone that wants the kind of money that they're going to need to get the person that wants, something will have to change somewhere with staff.
Yeah, I agree. I think that there's going to be no choice. I don't think we really have a choice as far as keeping the team as it is. I mean, I'm really scared that we're going to lose Manny Diaz and we'll probably lose five defensive players in the NFL draft, and I'm including all three linebackers, Trajan Bandy, Jackson. I mean, honestly, I could see us losing a lot next year, including Diaz, if something does not change. What was your score prediction for the game? I missed it.
If Rozier plays, Miami loses 24-13.
Okay.
If anybody else takes a snap at any point in the game, any point, Miami pulls out a dub 21-17. So still kind of close.
Okay.
I think that Duke's defensive line is lacking, and I think it's maybe finally an opportunity for Miami to showcase their run game a little bit, get DJ Dallas a couple of more carries. So I'm impressed overall with their quarterback, but our corners are pretty locked down. So, mm-hmm. I think he'll kind of keep it close, though, to be honest.
All right. Yeah, I was thinking it's going to be a close game. Are you going live? Everybody's asking me. You are going live for the game, right?
Yep. I'm going live here in just a second. I'm setting up right now as we speak. Yeah. Always running behind.
Yeah, I'm actually about to drop off because you know I like to watch her live and we like to do our thing. Hey, again, I appreciate everybody. I love all you guys. And again, Coop, you are my boy. Listen, guys, one more thing. Keep it looking. Look right here. Look right here. Miami's going to win the game. And this is why. Nicosi Perry, baby. Right. Hey, you know what? I got one more thing for you. Look, it's my dice. I'm going to put it on number 5, baby. Bam. Y'all ready? Love you guys. We'll holla. Coop, we're going to jump on your channel, man. Holla at you guys later.
I'll see you there, man.
All right, bet.